back, everybody. My next guest tonight is the winner of the 2015 Google Science Fair. Please welcome Olivia Hallisey. Olivia, thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me.
First of all, congratulations on winning the Google Science Fair. I've got the trophy is back here. This is the trophy they gave you.
Yeah.
Right there. That is awesome. It's fantastic. Now, how does Google hold a science fair? How is it different than a normal science fair?
So Google Science Fair is different because it's basically all online submissions until the top 20. In the top 20, they flew out to Google headquarters in California. But in the beginning, it's just you make your own website. You can either post a video or...
There's people all over the world.
Yeah, there was over 100 countries. There was a team from Bosnia, Taiwan. So it's really an international fair, and it's really accessible to anybody that has a project and wants to talk about it and show other people their work.
How old of a person are you?
I'm 17.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Now, this is examples of your project. What was your project and what does it do?
So my project is basically, I like to call it a pregnancy test for Ebola. So it's a
total... I'm sorry, a what?
A pregnancy test for Ebola.
And why did we need this? I didn't realize that's how it reproduced.
Well, I call it that because it's a visual process. So it's
all... Oh, like the stick that you pee on.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
It's all based on color change, and all you need is a sample from the possibly infected person.
So here's an example of what it might look like. Mm-hmm. What is this here? How would you use it?
So what you would do is you would put the sample right here, and then you would just put water on each of these load spots, mm-hmm. and that releases a chemical, and if the person is infected, then the center will turn blue.
And why did we need this?
Because current tests are expensive, complicated, and the most importantly, they require refrigeration. And this test uses a silk fibroin solution, which is just the proteins from silk cocoons. And that...
Don't patronize me. I know what a silk fibroin is. Please.
So...
I'm much older than 17. Okay, and so what is this one right here? This one has got a blue spot in the middle. Mm-hmm. What is that?
So this is would be what a positive result would look like.
Am I holding Ebola right
now? No.
I just didn't know. I didn't know if it got past security. All right. So why did this occur to you? Why not go with a baking soda volcano? That's a crowd pleaser. Why did you, you're 17-year-old living mm-hmm. in Connecticut, why did mm-hmm. it automatically, why did you think, let's do Ebola?
I think it was because I didn't really know what I wanted to do. I knew I was interested in science, and I wanted to do something that would have an impact on people's lives, but mm-hmm. then I didn't really know what direction I wanted to take with it, so I started looking at the news, and I'm in a science research class, and my teacher said, just look for something that inspires you, something that's relevant, and that was last fall when Ebola was really big in the news.
I remember,
and
yeah.
Yeah. And
a lot
so,
of Purell.
So I began looking at how can we limit the spread of Ebola, because the biggest problem I saw was how quickly mm-hmm. it was spreading.
Mm-hmm. It's a very ambitious thing to make your science project, to come up with a quick and easy test, you know, for Ebola. Mm-hmm. You know, how did it affect your life in any way? Did you ever say, guys, I'd love to go to the Lego movie with you, but I've got to fight a global pandemic first? You know, was it hard? Did it require a great deal of work to make?
Yeah, there was definitely a lot of time put into it and a lot of help from a lot of people. I had two mentors at Tufts University. I had my science mm-hmm. research teacher. Mm-hmm. I had to contact different companies to get the chemicals I needed. Mm-hmm. So it was a lot of work, but I mean, I think it was worth it.
I don't know whether to be inspired or intimidated by it. What year in high school are you?
I'm a junior.
You're a junior, so you gotta be thinking about colleges.
Yeah.
Are you gonna put this on your application?
I think so.
I would say, here's a hint. Don't put it first.
Okay.
Okay? Do like, you know, are you on like a team?
Mm-hmm, I swim.
Go swim team, then global pandemic.
Okay.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Olivia Hallisey, everybody. Google Science Fair champion.